I wrote a JSFX sequencer for Reaper called the Learningbaby. It's a MIDI sequencer that learns from your notes as you play. So before I show off the Learningbaby, let's just look through my track configuration. So I've got a track for drums that just transposes down by 2 octaves and feeds into a contact drum kit. And then I've got a track for synth that just ignores all of the drum notes and feeds into a contact bass. And then I've got this handy dandy keyboard visualizer that just kind of shows off which keys I'm pressing, so you can tell when I'm doing things and when I'm not. So let's throw the Learningbaby on the drums track and play some drums. Now, if you're thinking the Learningbaby interface looks familiar, that's because it is based on the Sequencer Baby V2. I just took that, added about 150 lines of code, and made the Learningbaby, which is the Sequencer Baby that learns, hence the name. So we'll just play the track, and you'll notice that the Learningbaby just starts advancing through the sequence just like a regular Sequencer Baby V2 would. And we can click to add and remove notes, and it still works just like a regular Sequencer Baby V2. But that is a bit lame, and we can do better. So I'll just wait for the beat to loop around and play a little drum pattern on my MIDI keyboard. And you notice the notes have filled in on the sequencer as I played them on my MIDI keyboard. And now that I'm not playing anything, the notes continue to repeat mostly the same way that I played them. And they got quantized to the sequencer grid, so I was a little bit off on a couple of notes the first time, but fixed that for the rest of the time. Now, as you can see, this bass right here is further off, and so it has pushed that to the next 16th note, but I can still go back in and fix that manually. I can leave it because it sounds cool, and if I really want to avoid doing that sort of thing, then I can just set my Learningbaby to 8th notes instead of 16th notes by just having the rate and probably also the sequence length, and then it can't quantize it to the wrong place in the 16th note because it doesn't quantize to 16th notes. So it quantizes to the settings that you have. So if you need like 32nd note triplets or something, just set your sequencer to be able to do that, and then play your notes and it'll do that. So that's pretty nifty for drums. So now that we've got our drum loop, and there's no reason that we have to just accept what we got. I meant to have snares, but they didn't turn up, so I can just add them now. And it just adds the new stuff without getting rid of what already existed, which is nifty. So let's throw that on with the synth. Now, since our synth is in a different place on the keyboard, we'll need to have our notes in a different place for the Learningbaby. So now we've got it set up properly, let's go play our bass line. Very helpful. I was holding down those notes the entire quarter note, but it only sequenced them for the first 16th note. And that's fine for the drums, but these are not drums. So I needed another solution. So let's change the repeated note setting from retrigger to extend, clear the sequencer, and try again. Now both of those are new features for Learningbaby that aren't part of the Sequencer Baby V2, and might come in handy on the Sequencer Baby V2, but are mostly important so that we can do stuff like this. Now you'll notice that it gave us the entire quarter note worth of stuff, and if we needed to start and stop at eighth notes, then we could have done that, and it still would have worked. And it isn't giving us a new note every time it hits it in the sequencer, it's just extending the note that exists. Now if you had the pattern that looked like this in the sequencer Baby 2, it would sound like this. Which isn't exactly great, at least for what I want. If you want this, then you can do this with Learningbaby, but if you want to be able to just do synth stuff and not mess around with your like sequencer scope and everything, and just hold notes down and have them sequenced, then this is the thing for you. So that's the Learningbaby, and instructions to download it will be in the description.